Nice tree there. Did you notice anything in it though? There was actually an owl there. Hi, my name is Mackenzie Rupert and I work for Colorado Parks and Wildlife in the Schools and Outdoor Learning Environments program. And today we're going to explore why you should give a hoot about owls. As you saw, owls are well adapted with camouflage to blend into their environment. They do this not only for safety, but also to hunt their prey as well.
Owls are predators. They eat other animals. Animals eaten by other animals are known as prey.
And camouflage isn't the only adaptation that owls have to hunt their prey. Look at those big eyes!
An owl's eyes can be up to 3% of its entire body weight. If a great horned owl was as large as a person, it would have eyes the size of oranges. Owls have such big eyes to begin with because many are nocturnal, meaning they are active at night and therefore need to see in the dark.
Not only do owls have huge eyes, but they have uniquely shaped eyes as well. As mammals, we have spherical eyes, which means that they're in the shape of a ball. So what we can do is we can look in all different directions without actually having to turn our heads. Owls, on the other hand, have a light bulb shaped eye, and they can't move their eyes in their skull like we can. And that's because they have a bone that goes around their eye called a sclerotic. So what do they do instead? Well, they actually simply just have to turn their head.
Do you know how far an owl can move its head? Owls can turn their heads about 270 degrees.
So carefully see how far you can turn your head without actually moving your body. As you can see, I can only really turn my head to my shoulder. And that's because as humans, we have fewer vertebrae or bones in our necks than owls. We have 7 vertebrae, while owls have 14. Owls are able to see their prey with their huge light bulb shaped eyes, but their hearing is just as important. Some owls have tough feathers on top of their heads that look like ears. But these only aid in camouflage. Owls do have ears though. They are just asymmetrical holes located on the sides of their heads. Eyes and ears are fine and dandy for locating prey, but how do owls catch their prey? So they actually have talons or claws. And these are super sharp for catching and carrying prey, and they're also really powerful.
For example, when clenched, a great horned owl's talons can take a force of about 28 pounds to open.
But in order for owls to catch their prey, they've got to be quiet. Owls are unique when it comes to flight, as they are silent. To do this, an owl's wing feathers are fringed. This allows for the wing to reduce noise from turbulence. So this rope has a frayed edge, and it represents a fringed feather. While this rope has a bunch of knots in it, and it represents a feather that's not fringed. Let's see if we can hear the difference. And we're gonna start with the non-fringed feather. Now, let's go ahead and try the fringed feather. The fringed feather actually helps break up sound, allowing the owl to fly silently to sneak up on its prey.
There are about 14 owl species found here in our state of Colorado.
The most common owl in Colorado is the great horned owl. And great horned owls have been documented in every single state park in Colorado. Oh, check it out. I think there's a great horned owl in that tree. These owls are active at night, and they enjoy things like chasing rodents and scavenging for food.
A more unique owl that you can find in Colorado is the burrowing owl. Burrowing owls are unique because instead of hunting just at night, they are active at any time. The burrowing owl is the only owl in Colorado who lives underground in burrows. They are found around open grassy areas where you might also find prairie dog colonies. Colorado Parks and Wildlife spends time monitoring burrowing owls to learn how to best manage owls and other species that depend on prairie dog habitat. These and the other owls of Colorado have some amazing adaptations that make them successful hunters in their ecosystems. But just as important as they are for the ecosystem, they are also important to us. For example, owls provide natural pest control and even reduce disease spread when they are out hunting.
If you're wondering what you can do to show that you give a hoot about owls, Here are some ideas. First, you can start by properly disposing of your food or any other trash in the appropriate trash or compost bin.
Improperly disposed of food can attract rodents to roads. This can cause owls to be injured by cars when they try to catch their prey.
Second, you can learn about owls, which is what you're doing right now when you're watching this video, so good job! And lastly, you can actually volunteer to support owl conservation with Colorado Parks and Wildlife and other organizations.
There are many things that you can do to help Colorado Parks and Wildlife care for owls. Whether it's keeping your food off of roads, learning about owls, or volunteering, you can show owls that you give a hoot about them. Conservation starts small.
Thanks for learning with Wild Classroom. Let us know which owl fact you like learning about the most in the comment section below.